Thank you all for taking some time out of your day to be here with me. If you're a member of the community, I welcome you back. If this is your first time seeing one of my videos, I encourage you to hit the subscribe button as well as turn the notifications on. I'm Patrick Zimmerman, and today we'll be talking about and analyzing the business of innovative industrial properties. I said if the Enterprise Product Partner stock analysis got 5 likes, then I would release this video as well. This is my second favorite real estate investment trust currently. That video got 14 likes. I thank you all very much. And I encourage you to go check that video out after this one if you have not yet seen it. It's a really great master limited partnership, which pays out a pretty safe dividend around 11%. Innovative Industrial Properties is a real estate investment trust which concerns themselves with the business of medical cannabis. Although this may be a point of contention for some, I believe they are in a good position to keep growing their business for years to come. If you're not exactly sure how a real estate investment trust runs, you can go check out my stock analysis on Store Capital. I believe that was stock analysis number 1. I will link that in the description as well as throw it up on the screen. In the first 4 minutes of that video, we discuss real estate investment trusts and how they function. You can gain the knowledge that way, and I also recommend that you watch the rest of the video as I believe that's an incredibly strong, safe investment despite the uncertainty of the economic times we're in. Here is the 1-year chart for Innovative Industrial Properties, stock ticker IIPR. They are currently trading at $127.90, and they're offering a dividend yield of 3.79%. The last 2 stocks that we discussed and analyzed, Enterprise Product Partners and Store Capital, were both trading on sale from the coronavirus crash in March. IIPR, as you can see here on the 1-year chart, has already surpassed their pre-March highs from the coronavirus crash. I wouldn't necessarily take this as a reason not to buy in. Unlike the last 2 we've talked about, they are not currently trading on sale. As we continue our discussion today, I believe you will feel much more comfortable buying into the company for the long term, as I believe they are in a unique position to corner the market and keep growing that stock price despite being a real estate investment trust. As I said before, IIPR currently offers a dividend yield of 3.79%. They've been growing their dividend consistently for the past 3 years. I know this doesn't seem very long, and we talk on this channel that you want to invest in companies who have consistent long-term dividend increases. As you'll see on the next slide, they've only been publicly trading for those 3 years. One of the things that I do not like about IIPR and kind of makes me nervous is that payout ratios above 98%. Although real estate investment trusts are obligated to pay 90% of their taxable income as dividends to the shareholders, because IIPR's payout ratio is almost 100%, that means they don't necessarily currently have a ton of cash flow coming in order to increase their business operations. By no means is that stopping me from buying additional shares. It's just something I like to keep a close eye on. As medical cannabis use becomes less taboo, I believe Innovative Industrial Properties will have an easier time increasing their income levels, especially because they have already obtained a multitude of different properties as well as customers. Here is the complete dividend payout history from IIPR. As I stated before, they've only been publicly trading for the past 3 years. And I really like how over the first 2 years, they were able to increase their dividend payout from about 13 cents to upwards of 50 cents. And in just the past year alone, they've gotten that payout slightly above 50 cents to already over $1 per share per quarter. Innovative Industrial Properties currently holds 61 properties in their real estate portfolio. All of those 61 properties equate to 4.5 million rentable square feet, in which case 99.2% of that is currently leased out. In addition to that space being currently leased out, the average lease length is also about 16 years. I consider this to be incredibly safe, and it it should definitely be an elevating factor in your decision to buy into the company or not. When we talked about Store Capital a couple weeks ago, we discussed how their average lease length of 14 years put them in a very safe position to hold. Innovative Industrial Properties has plus 2 years on them in that sense. Likewise, I believe this makes IIPR a safe REIT to hold in your portfolio as well. From a price performance standpoint, they received $97.38 million from quarter two in 2020 as total revenue. And they also have currently just above $1 billion tied up in invested capital, which is a driving factor for that revenue coming in and should help them build their business for years to come. So before we continue talking about Innovative Industrial Properties and why I believe they would be a good REIT to hold in your portfolio, I want to just discuss a little bit about the medical grade cannabis industry and why I believe this offers IIPR great growth potential in the future. From 2018 to 2019, U.S. regulated cannabis sales increased by 37%. This was from $9.1 billion to $12.4 billion. We can expect cannabis sales to continue to grow as 33 of the 50 U.S. states have now legalized medical-grade cannabis use. And according to IIPR themselves, 93% of Americans support patient access to medical-use cannabis. In addition to that, it's important to note that medical grade cannabis isn't just used to treat symptoms like seizures. Rather, it can offer help for a variety of different medical conditions. Some of them that IIPR has listed here are cancer, HIV, AIDS, any pain or nausea, seizures, as I said, muscle spasms, multiple sclerosis, PTSD, migraines, arthritis, Parkinson's. It can even help soothe the pain from drastic spinal cord injuries and even some terminal illnesses. As I stated earlier about IIPR cornering the market, I believe these stats which we have discussed shine great light on that, as now over 50% of the United States allows their citizens access to medical-grade cannabis. It is available to over 200 million Americans, and the demand for it is sure to go up. The next thing I want to talk about in regard to Innovative Industrial Properties is their diversification by state. As we've discussed multiple times on this channel, diversification is very important to hedge the risk of not only your business, but your investment portfolio as well. Of IIPR's 61 properties and 4.5 million square feet, they are currently diversified into 16 different states. Their largest being the likes of Illinois, Pennsylvania, and Massachusetts. Something I like to consider when looking at this is that, as we just discussed, medical grade cannabis is legal in 33 different states now, and IIPR is currently diversified into 16 of those 33. This gives them great potential to continue to diversify across the country, and likewise, they will have the ability to drastically increase the number of properties they hold, as well as that square footage statistic. Before we get into the earnings and performance of Innovative Industrial Properties, I want to remind everyone to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so they can stay up to date on the content. Also, if you liked the video so far, I encourage you to go down and hit the like button. We got 14 likes on stock analysis number 2, so let's shoot for 15 likes here, and I will upload the next stock analysis video to the playlist. If you'd like to see that, all you gotta do is go smash the like button below. Also, make sure you stick around till the end of the video, and we will be discussing IIPR's leaseback program, which is one of the reasons that I believe they have such great growth potential, and will keep that revenue increasing and consistently rolling in. Here are the financial results of Innovative Industrial Properties since they went public in December of 2016. The light blue bar outlines the general expenses, which is essentially how much IIPR has been spending. The bar in the middle is adjusted funds from operation, which offers insight on how much a real estate investment trust is bringing in from operating their properties. And the dark blue line is the total revenue which IIPR has received each quarter. What I really like about this chart and what makes me really bullish on the stock is that the expenses have not increased much since the company's IPO. With that being said, the funds from operation, which IIPR receives, as well as that quarterly revenue, have consistently been able to increase despite the expenses staying relatively the same year over year. This isn't only great from an investor standpoint, but I also believe it offers valuable insight on how the management team is performing. They're able to keep those expenses down as the funds from operation and total revenue have increased every quarter since IPO. If Innovative Industrial Properties is able to keep the expenses at a constant rate from quarter to quarter as they have done as of yet, and the funds from operation continue to increase, then eventually we will be able to see the total revenue grow exponentially compared to the expenses, which has stayed pretty much at a steady level so far. Here are the total stockholder returns of Innovative Industrial Properties in black, the S&P 500 in purple, and the National Association of Real Estate Investment Trusts in yellow since the IPO of IIPR in December of 2016. So you can see here that the lines of the S&P 500 and NA REIT have been trending upwards much more slowly than that of IIPR. I don't want you to think that they've stayed on the same level for the last 3 years. They have been slightly increasing. It just looks like they are flat because the stockholder returns of IIPR have been so drastic compared to the two other stocks. If you bought up shares of Innovative Industrial Properties when they IPO'd in 2016, you would have been able to see a 600% increase in your capital invested as of halfway through 2019. And as of September of 2020, they're still at that 500% increase range, which is obviously still incredibly profitable. This is one of the charts that make me consider IIPR to be much more than just a value company. Although they are just a real estate investment trust, which oftentimes have trouble growing their companies because they have to pay out such a drastic percentage of their earnings every year to the shareholders, I do like to consider IIPR as somewhat of a growth stock because the medical cannabis industry as a whole has the ability to keep performing very well in the years to come. We've already seen upwards of 500% increases in stock price for IIPR, although that is liable to fizzle out and become more constant at some point. Because they are currently in such a controversial market, which has the ability to continue to grow at drastic rates, I expect the business of IIPR to grow in hand with that. Another reason I consider IIPR to be somewhat of a growth stock and why I don't necessarily worry so much about that 98% payout ratio despite them being a real estate investment trust is because of their triple net sale-leaseback program. This allows IIPR to acquire freestanding industrial and retail properties from state-licensed medical use cannabis operators. Once the properties are acquired by IIPR, they are then leased back under long-term absolute net lease agreements. It's important to note here that Innovative Industrial Properties only deals with medical use cannabis operators who are already state licensed. Additionally, Innovative Industrial Properties likes to get into business with well-capitalized companies who have been acting in accordance with the state laws dependent upon where the property is located. In my opinion, this is one of the strongest reasons why IIPR is slated to continue to grow in the future. They have been able to acquire all 61 properties and currently have no debt at all on their balance sheet. Not only is the sale-leaseback program a great way to keep them growing, but because they are able to acquire properties without accruing any debt, they should be able to continue to increase their dividend payments to the shareholder, which in turn, I believe, will be a factor in the stock price continuing to rise over time. I hope you all enjoyed the third stock analysis on the channel. If you haven't seen my other two, either Enterprise Product Partners or Store Capital, I encourage you to go check those out. I believe both those companies to be great stocks to hold in regard to increasing your portfolio's yield, in turn creating an additional cash flow stream. Innovative Industrial Properties, on the other hand, I believe will be not only a value stock as they are a dividend-paying real estate investment trust, but also can offer you some great growth potential for the future, and that is the reason that I am so bullish on them as of now. If you enjoyed the video and the content today, I encourage you to smash the like button below, as well as subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. As always, I'm Patrick Zimmerman. Thank you for your time, and enjoy the rest of your day.